Right, I thought, because we're on a water type event, it only seemed fitting to come down to the seaside. So we're down at Western. I've been here a long time ago, but it's full of crazy spawns. It's known for spawning for alligators. As soon as we rocked up, a totodile spawned. So, fingers crossed, it's going to be some mega catching, maybe. Right, okay, so there you go, totodile spawned, so we're going to get that. I'm going to turn this around so you guys can see us catch him. I might go screen record a free time. I reckon I'm getting loads of glare. Let's put you guys in there, that might work. Okay, so we'll bury him up. We'll throw him an ultra ball. I always find it so much harder throwing balls like this. It's just from a slightly different angle. You might see a whole lot of GoPro risk reflection in your screen, but nice, first shot. Happy days. Yeah, so we got our great throw bonus, a first throw bonus, and a Pokemon court bonus. Nice, in a second I'm gonna stick a lucky egg on, but we only need two more candies for a Croconaw, and we're definitely gonna do that today as well. Right, okay, so we're gonna do a bit of, sort of housekeeping before we get too carried away. I was gonna say we could go down here, but the first bit...
It's a bit wet.
Yeah, looks mildly moist. I think
he's
a... Why you wear boots? Got a couple of friends here today as well, so yeah, they're here to keep me in check by taking the out of me. I think we'll go down and have a look and see how wet feet we can't get. And I think Charlie and I might be wussy, and Wes is clearly the only proper man in the boots. Got proper man in the boots. My God! I tell you, if he keeps taking the miss out of me, he might end up being the man in the boot. I tell you, it actually looks all right. Looks pretty
not
good. Let's have a go.
Yeah, it's just. Down
there, yeah, it's all good. Yeah, just don't jump in the bit over there by accident. You've seen this, is really cool. So this is like Western
nice.
Marine Lake. It's proper lovely. So as long as we don't get any like surge flash tides, you know, some like, you know, like sort of Leviathan, like Queen of Atlantis style. I don't even know. I've invented a film. There you go. Picture a film, Atlantis, Queen of whatever the hell I just said. Yeah, nice. We'll go with that. So anyway, as I was saying, a few bits of housekeeping. Obviously, we're wandering around, we're catching loads of stuff. So first thing, lucky egg on. So we've now got 29 minutes of lucky egg. That's really cool. And noisy waterage going on. Then we're gonna make sure we've got all of our eggs on. We've currently got, in fact, actually we're not. We're not gonna put the rest on yet, because if you look here, we're 1.3 on a 2K and 4.8 on a 5K. So they're going to go in a minute. So what I'll do is I'll cure the others up properly. I've said this before, guys. Make sure you cure your eggs up together. So start your 5Ks. When you're 3K in, put your 2Ks on. Then you can make the most out of your lucky eggs. It works really, really well, especially if you plan a budget. If you're not sort of spending coins to sort of add stuff in, it really, really helps. So for the time being, on that little upkeep note, we're going to go and see if we can find... Look at this for a screen. Check it out. Totodile, Squirtle, Bulbasaur. All we need is a Charmander and a few other things on this, and it's like starter central. Cool. Anyway, one more little pan around at this rather nice season. It's like being at Viridian City usually here. There's like so many blooming electric types. I'm right, hang on. Got the Pokemon, check it out with my Pokemon fact squad in the back. Is Viridian City was electric town, wasn't it?
Yeah.
See, look. Yeah. I'm terrible, I like played the original games ages ago, but you know, these guys are far more hot on all the proper Pokemon Go beta. I'm a fake Pokemon Go fan. I'm like a, just like a Go Ed. Right, anyway, I'll leave you there and we'll go and catch some stuff in a minute. Intercept you guys there, as we were just saying, 5k eggs going. Let's pick you up from that walk across the thing, and what we'll do, in fact, we'll go and put you over here and we'll look and check out, see what this 5k egg was. So I've got a little bit of a makeshift tripod. I've got a makeshift tripod as in an actual tripod, but boom. Whoa, right, cool. 5k egg, let's watch it together. I'll come this way. What do you want? A Muk, Grimer, Vulpix. That's rubbish. No good. 410. Haven't got enough to do another evolve just yet. We got a horsey sitting here. Hop hip to one other side. And we've got a 2K that's probably waiting to go in a minute. Yeah, 1.5. So that'll go in a minute and we'll check out what that is in just a moment. You can see where we've come from actually. We just see all the way across the back over here. Come along the little walkway. And then there's the sort of the little island at the corner of the Marine Lake, which is really sweet. And we've got that one as well. So that puts us up to 139. And that works a treat. And we've even got a little Bellsprout having a bath for some obscure reason. So I think we're going to carry on wandering along this path over here, up the top and around, and see if we can find more cool stuff and maybe even evolve some stuff actually, especially as we've got this lucky egg on. So we'll see how we get on. Right, we're going to get the one hit a quitter on this one. Bosh. He's in. Come on. One. Two. Three. Boom. Happy days. Toad, I was caught. So we got a curveball and we got a first throw bonus. Let's IV check it for you guys whilst we're where we want. Simply Amazes Me. May not be great in battle. So that's cool. But however, 30 candies. I think, to be honest with you, if it carries on like this, there is such a strong chance that we could end up with a Feraligatr today. Whether that's just one totally spawned in the wild and we end up catching it, or we just carry on catching Totodiles like the Ganon fashion. As I said, Lee, Viridian City, two Magnites, sick. Right, so these guys are carrying 11 up the gym. I'm going to carry on my little mini evolution spree. Right, gym leveled up. Screen recorder on because I can't wait anymore. We've got two metal coats. One happened with the Steelix the other day, but we're going to do a Scyther. We've got 89%. Put it on. I've been waiting for this. I've already done one Scyther, but its moveset was the worst moveset. It was literally the worst moveset possible. It was shocking. There we go. Bosh. Caesar, or should I say? Fury Cutter X Scissor. It's a double bug type. I'll have to check that in a minute, but yes, another one. Right, okay, so we'll come back. In fact, actually, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to check it now. We're going to check it now. Let's have a look. Okay. Yes. 97.7%. Absolutely happy with that. Double bug type. There is a double steel type with bullet punch and iron head, but also at 100%, so next to, so 97.7%, I think, to be honest with you, that's going to get powered up, so really cool moveset, nice. Right, the interestingness continues. We've got a Hitmonchan now, which I'm not going to pogo plus. I thought I'd pogo plus it. Is he going to have good CP? 1486. Wow. What was yours? 1486. Hello. I can't throw Ultra Balls though, apparently. Great shot. Ultra Ball and a Raspberry. This should be in the bag. One, two, three. Boom. Hitmonchan. What moves? Bullet Punch and Thunder Punch. That's no fighting type moves then at all then. That's one steel type move and an electric type move. Yeah, it's the same, yeah. That's the thing, if people have sort of forgotten as well, the only thing that changes on your Pokemon when other people catches is the CP buff. Yeah, no, the IVs, moves, everything will stay exactly the same. The only thing that basically changes is the CP value of the Pokemon. So, yeah. Hitmonchan, rubbish moves. Charlie lucked in with a low CP there. Yeah. Right, so we're going to carry on going on. We're currently stalking a few more Totodiles we've got on nearby, so we're going to go and catch them. Right, we're at the first of two Totodiles, so we've got him spawned. I thought I'd turn the screen recorder on this one. I don't mind turning the screen recorder. It just feels like, for me personally, I mean, I love filming this for you guys, but I love the gameplay, and every time I've got to start a screen recorder to catch a Pokemon, it's like, I don't know, for me it detracts from it a little bit. So that hence why I would sort of rather go, oh look, here's this, and you know, it means you'd have to look at my big ugly head anyway. It's, you know, win for everyone. So we'll Raspberry him. And I'm still looking. I don't know if it, what is this, has anyone appraised it yet? Has it got good IVs? Or do we still need a good one to evolve into Croconaw? Because we have got enough candies for that now. It's a shame we're not picking up pineapple berries at the moment. We could do with a few of those. What are we doing? So is it above 80%? No, it's not. So not above 80%. That's fine.
So we're up to 36 candy. We'll transfer that one away. So that takes us up to 37. And we're cool. So we're slowly making our way back down. You can see on the map. So we're just on the top part of the Marine Lake. We're coming back down here again, back to where we started. And then we may jump in the car and go and see if we can find a park. Or we may just do another loop. We'll see what happens. So what I do need to do in a minute, though, is once I get another lucky egg, which hopefully in a minute, I've just got a 10K. So we'll put that on and get that going now. Where are we at? So 10K, start incubation, and we'll put that on. So we'll start smashing through that, get some 5Ks on, get some 2Ks on, and then we will be cooking on gas. We'll Pokemon Go Plus, that Remora Red, are we going to get it? One, two, three. No good, but we can swipe the Pokestop. I love this. Look, push the button. There it goes. Love it. Best invention ever. Now only 35 quid, I think. I got mine from the Nintendo store. I don't think that counts as a plug, because I'm playing Pokemon Go. But again, I think that works. Hashtag not sponsored, just in case. See you later. Right, okay, so we're at this snubble. I'm gonna sit down here so you guys have got a bit of a decent backdrop for this one. I still haven't got a Gramble, and I still need a good IV as well. So what we'll do is we'll Ultra Ball this just in case, because it's good, it's got good CP, so it's a good candidate for an evolution. And Gramble's okay, it's okay. It's not like, you know, oh, it's jumped straight out.
Not likely to make any headway in battle.
Oh, is it rubbish? Okay, so it's just some candy. Okay, so Wes just called it, so it's not that good. So we'll go back to our great balls. If you've noticed, I have been great balling everything today. Main reason being I've got a load. I'm saving my normal Pokeballs from my Pokemon Go Plus as well. So, you know, so that's all cool. But we do need, Gramble would be a new evolution. It would be a new entry in the decks. So yeah, so we do need to get those candies in. So yeah, 596. We'll hold on to it, good level Pokemon, and we'll get this Voltorb over here. You know, obviously we've got water type event today, but however, it's really common to have electric types by the sea. Go back to the joke we said at Viridian City. I think, you know, Niantic sort of a bit onto that and carried it on. So we'll great ball this, and then what we'll do is we'll get back down to the beginning and we will carry on straight out, and it's going to run. Oh no, the wild Voltorb there. That's a new bit of text actually, I've noticed that. It just said, oh no, it run away. But now it says, oh no, the wild Voltorb fled. So that's a slightly new bit of text. But anyway, I'll leave you that view and we'll crack on with what we're doing. Oh, hello. Can I just have a look at Charlie's 5K? Oh, hello. Is that a new? Have you got one?
No, I haven't got one.
Hey, happy days. I haven't got a Yanmar either.
Bargain.
Sweet. That's the first Yanmar I've seen. Happy days. Right, we're going to go to some really, really commonly undisclosed fast food joint that shall remain nameless because we're already hungry. See you in a bit. We've got another Magikarp and he's out on the pier. Is this going to be a shiny one? Is it Ek? So on that note, I'm not going to let you stick around and watch me catch my 700th Magikarp of the day. We are going to get back to the car though, but what a lovely day. I think actually the next bit you'll see us now is we'll be at Breen. See you at Breen, guys. I don't think they heard me. Okay, so we've changed the location now. We are now at the very, very rural, very little bit more chilled out Breen Down. If you look in the background, it's literally full of amazing cliffs, beautiful countryside. I used to go climbing here an awful lot. I haven't been for a very long time, but it's stunning. It's a beautiful location. The sun's still out. We've still got Mantines coming out of our ear holes, if you can see that through the glare on the screen. And yeah, it's all right. It's really, really nice. So we're going to have a look around. This is kind of quite well known for some really, really crazy spawns. You know, I know I've seen pictures from the local Facebook group of, you know, for alligator and all sorts of cool stuff down here. So that's what we're going to go and try and find. And along the way, catch some more cool stuff. That was a one hitter with the Pokeball on the Mantine, by the way. Wing attack, water pulse, not a bad move set. So yeah, we'll keep catching some stuff. We'll keep you guys informed and we'll see how we get on. So yeah, nice. Okay, so now we're going up here. What the hell? Okay, up we go. As you can see, we just flashed the screen recorder up the top, which I'm going to get first, probably full-heartedly, as there's a Magikarp up here, is this Butterfree. Because you don't see wild Butterfrees, you don't. So 687, not the best CP, but have it a really cool wild catch. And if you look at this view, oh, wow. To me, this is why I love being outside. This is why I taught outdoors for 15 years. It's stunning. We're down at the beach. You know, who says that being a big geek means you sit at a computer all day long? I'm a monstrous geek. I'm out in the countryside playing a game. So, frankly, guys, oh, it's amazing. And he's got away and he's flown up to the top of the screen. Right, let's pay attention to this for 2 seconds. Hold on. Ultra ball. Great shot.
He's not going.
He's not going. Is he? Where's his stat behind the camera? And apparently he's still playing silly buggers with Wes. Mine's in. Butterfree was caught.
Oh, Jesus.
Butterfree was caught. And let's catch this Magikarp now. What are we going to get? Gold one? No, of course not. 92 CP. We're still throwing great balls at everything, saving up our normal balls for our Pokemon Go Plus, which is excellent. So I'm just going to stand to one side. I'm assuming I'm still in shots today. But yeah, get this shot in the background. Magikarp was caught. Still not a shiny one. We're working towards that. But yeah, amazing, amazing, amazing. We've got Yellow Gym at the top, which I think we're all just going to try and take down together because none of us are yellow. Pokemon Go Plus is going for this spinner act. We'll use that. But for the time being, we can get to the top of the hill and see what else we can catch and just enjoy more of this view. We'll see you at the top. It's a little bit windy up here. I think they're lying to me. What we got up here? Natu. Bellsprout, another Natu. Oh, hang on. Well, so there's a few bits going on. There's a few bits going on. And then a yellow gym at the top, which is level 8. It's a big gym. But it is beautiful up here, to be honest with you. There could have been nothing up here and it would have been worth the trip if I turn you guys around. There's Weston, so that's where we was before. So you can see the new pier, which you saw earlier on. You can see the old, very much windswept, slightly battered pier in the background. And the marine lake is somewhere between the two, which was where we was which is where we was catching all the cool stuff before. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna flake out here for a bit, hopefully catch some stuff, and yeah, see what spawns. But at the moment it's just quite nice, just chilling up here and seeing what turns up. So we'll go from here and see what happens. It's a little bit windy. Woo. Yeah, it's a wind. There's none of it. Don't worry, we're fine. I kind of if we hide in here and talk really quietly behind the wind, am
gonna be alright. Right, we're going back to the car. Because it's as cold as you probably think it is. And there may be more.
Okay, this is going to be the most speculative shot in the world. This is going to be a golden Magikarp. No, it's not. Okay, I've got a confession to make. We've just got back to the car park. My hair is everywhere, by the way, from walking down the window. Just going through my sort of collection of Pokemon from the day. And I may have got something with my Pokemon Go Plus. We've got a freaking shiny Magikarp. I've checked the IVs and what are we on? Decent. It's all right. But however, it can be a shiny Gyarados, and that is really exciting. We've got 900 candy. You know, I can wait. I've got a 96%. What we're going to do now is we're going to evolve this right before the end, and we're going to do it now. I'm just super psyched about this. While we're doing it, let's just have this view in the background, shall we? Here we go. Here we go. After that technical hitch there, I'm really psyched about this. It's a red Gyarados. That's so sick. Bite and crunch. See, why could it not be bite hydro pump? What's the Wes's trying to show me something now? Dragon tail hydro pump. That's a good moveset. That's not a... Wes has just done his first Gyarados as well. Normal one. But yeah, bite and crunch. Two dark type moves. Really unusual. I suppose that's quite fitting for a red one. But however, we've got a red Gyarados in that one there. Remember to like this if you liked it, guys. Remember to subscribe to never miss any of the stuff that you see on the channel. We've got so much cool stuff summer coming up. I've got about a 5-vigil schedule that are coming up soon. Just stay tuned. And we've got a community vid as well coming up. So, yeah. Enjoy, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.